वसुदेवसुदं देवं गंसचानूरमर्दनं देवगी परमानन्दं कृष्णं वन्दे जगद्गुरुम्।
Dear Swamiji, how to find out whether somebody is enlightened or not? Arjuna asks the same question. I think in the second chapter, Krishna answers this same question. Let me give you the sloka. Yes. Arjuna asks, Stita prajnyasya kavasha samadhistasya kesavaha Stita dikim prabhashete kima sida prajedakim Stita prajnyasya kavasha samadhistasya kesava. Arjuna says, O Krishna, what are the symptoms of one whose consciousness is thus merged in transcendence? How does he speak and what is his language? How does he sit and how does he walk? This is the question from second chapter. Of course, in the second chapter, Arjuna is not ready to even relate with Krishna. That is why Krishna is saying about enlightenment. Immediately Arjuna asks, how to find out whether somebody is enlightened or not? How an enlightened man will walk and sit? Actually, he is addressing this question to find out whether Krishna is enlightened or not. For example, he says, these are the qualities of enlightenment. Immediately Arjuna is asking, Krishna explains about enlightenment. Immediately Arjuna is asking, how an enlightened man will behave, tell me. It means what? First thing, he is doubting the Krishna, Krishna's authority. He wants some scale with which he can measure Krishna. But one important thing, even though out of compassion Krishna tries to answer here logically, you cannot logically measure. That is the ultimate truth. Just out of compassion, Krishna tries to give some idea. Actually, Krishna is just postponing the question. He is not answering it. There are two, three methods. Actually, one person came to me and he asked me, Swamiji, please tell me how to realize God, how to achieve God, teach me something about God, Atman. I just told him, please come sit, how are you, from where, what you are doing, what your wife is doing, how is your family. I started talking and he also started talking something. Conversation went on. After that, he was with me more than 3 hours, but he did not raise the subject again. He forgot the very question. He did not even remember the question which he asked. He did not even come to the subject. Then understand how much this question is important for his life. How much this question is important for his life. He is asking just because he has to ask something. You have seen a Swamiji. You have to show that you have some spiritual interest. Someday you have to relate with him. And you have to show you also know few words. I have seen few pandits. They come and stand in front of me and recite long, big, big terminologies. Big, big words. One guy came to me and asked me, Swamiji, tell me the mantra. How to do Vasya Ashtadasabhuja Mahalakshmi Durga Devi is asking that 1800 Kali, give me the mantra to do Vashya. Of that 1800 Kali, she should listen what I say. Give me the mantra. I told him, first learn some mantra to make your wife listen to your words. First learn how to handle two-handed women. Then you can go around about learning how to work with 1800 women. You don't know the basic science of life. How to live with your wife. You wanted to learn big words. And we always waste our life with big words. With big terminologies. And this guy, he forgot the question. He forgot the question. Afterward, he spent with me 2-3 hours. He's not even remembered the question. The question asked just because you should speak something. It is not his quest. Questions are answered in one way. Quest is addressed in the other way. Please be very clear. Questions are answered in one way. First is addressed in the other way. One person came to me, young man. And he asked me, Swamiji, have you seen God? It seems he has read a lot of Ramakrishna Vivekananda literature. And I could see that he was wearing the Vivekananda's dollar in his neck, around his neck. Have you seen God? I asked him. Have you read Vivekananda's life? He said, yes. I am asking you how the Vivekananda asked Ramakrishna. Same day I am asking you, have you seen God? I just cut out of his shirt so that he should not run away. Then I told him, Ramakrishna said, he has seen. And simply Vivekananda followed Ramakrishna. His whole life he was with Ramakrishna. Now I tell you, not only I have seen, I will show you, come. The fellow ran away. He just disappeared. He escaped and ran away. Then I told him, don't ask the question if you can't take the responsibility. Just because you read Ramakrishna Vivekananda's life, Vivekananda asked Ramakrishna, true, but he had the courage, guts to follow Ramakrishna. When Ramakrishna said, yes, he followed. I told him, not only I say I have seen, I will show you, come. Fellow just escape. We always waste our life with empty words. Question will be addressed in a different way. Quest is addressed in a different way. Here, it is a question. Arjuna is asking a question. It is not quest. He is asking, Stitha Prajnyasya Kavasha Samadhistasya Keshava Stidadi Kim Prabhasheda Kima Sida Prajeda Kim. How to find out something is a question or quest, you know? If it is a quest, you will have only one word. You will put one question and you will stop, you will wait for answer. If it is just an intellectual question, you will continuously arrange 10 words. Here he is asking 10 questions. How does he speak? What is his language? How does he sit? And how does he walk? Means he is not even interested in answer. If you are interested in answer, you will stop with the first question. You will wait for the answer. Then you will put the next question. But here he goes on putting the questions. Means pure intellectual. Arjuna is on the process. He is on the process. Arjuna, then Krishna starts. Of course, please be very clear. Krishna is not answering. He is just postponing the question. He knows answering this question is no way going to help. So he is answering in such a way, neither Arjuna will feel he did not receive the answer, nor the Arjuna can come to a conclusion with this answer. Here he is giving an answer. Prajahadi yada kaman sarvan partha manogatan atmanye vatmanadushta siddhapragnyastha docchade. He says, Partha, when a man casts off and controls all types of desires and selfish deeds which arise from the mind, and when he remains satisfied with himself in his consciousness, in his eternal bliss, then he is said to have a stable mind and vice. All right. How many of you can find out with this scale whether somebody is enlightened or not? Tell me. Here he is given the answer. Can any of us use this answer? After answer, you will have more problem than before answer. Actually, sometime by giving answer, you will create more questions than before the question was there. Originally, if Arjuna had 10 questions, after this answer, he will have 20 questions. Because the answer says, who is completely established in his own consciousness, who is satisfied in his own consciousness, he is said to have stable mind and vice. And he is telling, he is said to have. He is not giving from his experience. He could have said, he is Siddhapragna. But he is not telling that. He is believed or said to have stable mind and is wise. He is just trying to escape, putting the blame on the tradition. He is not directly coming the front. He is not confronting the question directly. He is just passing it away. He is just passing it away. Ramakrishna, whenever a close disciples ask for some boon, he will tell, don't worry, I will take care. Whenever he wants to avoid somebody, he will tell, go to Kali and pray. Go to Kali and pray. He will tell them, no, no, go there, go to the Dwadas Mandir is there, go there, the Kali is there, go and pray. He will not put himself front. He will just avoid. That's the same thing Krishna is doing here. He is saying, it is believed. So that if some more question comes, he can always escape. Next sloka, Dukkeshvanut, Dukkeshvanut, Vignamana, Sukeshu Vigadaspraha, Vidaraga Bayakrodha, Siddhadir Muni Ruchyate. Translation goes, one whose mind remains free from emotional agitation, even in miseries, and does not search for pleasure, and who is free from attachment, fear and anger, is called enlightened man who is in eternal bliss, eternal consciousness. If your inner space is not filled with too much of emotional attachment, it can freely flow in the life. It can freely flow in the life. Many people ask me, Swamiji, continuously, how are you able to quote from so many scriptures? From where you are able to get so much of information? How are you able to speak so many things? I tell them, very simple secret. So many people ask me, how are you able to have such a sharp memory? Give us some technique to have sharp memory. This is the ultimate important technique, to have sharp memory. How to have sharp memory? Just drop the emotional attachment. It's just how computer works. If your hard disk is filled with high resolution photographs, what will happen? It will crash. If it is filled only with the word document, you can handle any amount of memory. Your emotional attachment makes word document into high resolution photographs. Word documents are transformed into high resolution photographs, high resolution pictures by your emotional attachment to it. When you emotionally attach to it, again and again you remember only that. That portion takes away majority of your inner space. Your whole inner space is swallowed, taken away by that one particular picture. If at all we can do surgery in your inner space, most of your inner space will be filled just with 4 or 5 photographs. Your wife or family or your spouse, your immediate family. Only those 4 or 5 pictures will be there, high resolution. 90% of your hard disk is filled just with that 4 or 5 high resolution pictures. That is why you don't have memory space left for any other work. Your whole memory space is already occupied. No memory space is left. But if at all you can bring down, if at all you can reduce the emotional attachment for this few high resolution pictures, you will be able to handle more word documents. More word documents. That is the secret here Krishna is giving. Whose inner space is completely free, whose hard disk is completely clean, who can process any information at any time, whose inner space is open, free and sharp, he is called Sthita Prajna. He is called the person who is in eternal consciousness. These are all few answers Krishna is giving for Arjuna. But I tell you, with this scale, you will never be able to find who is enlightened or who is unenlightened by using the scales intellectually. Simply impossible. If you want an honest answer, I can tell one thing. You can never find logically. If somebody is enlightened, when you see him, simply something will happen inside your heart. Beyond your intellect, your whole heart will fall in tune with him. Simply you will not be able to forget him. You will be pulled. Your whole being will be attracted. Your whole being will be automatically filled by him. You will not know what is happening to you. You yourself will not be able to understand, analyze logically. You will be just waiting. When can I see him next? When can I see him next? Simply your heart will fall in love. I can say, with masters you raise in love. With ordinary people you fall in love. With masters you raise in love. Simply something will happen in your space. Beyond your control, beyond your logic, your heart knows he is enlightened. Simply you can't say no to him. Be very clear. If that happens, that person is going to help you. That person is going to show you the life. That person is your master. If that doesn't happen, don't bother. Continue your search. You will meet the right person. Continue your search. You will meet the right person. Don't bother who is enlightened, who is not enlightened. Intellectually, you cannot find out. If somebody is going to help you, simply your heart will fall in tune with him. If it falls in tune with him, even if he is not enlightened, he will help you. You will be helped by him. Even if he is not enlightened, you will be helped by him. If your heart has not fallen in tune, even if he is enlightened, he is not for you. Forget about it. So, you don't have to use your head at all. Just relax. Your heart knows how to show you the right path. how to guide you in the right path. Your heart is the judge, which will guide you automatically at the right time, in the right moment, towards the right person. So let the divine Parabrahma Krishna guide us all to the right energy, to the right attitude and the right experience. Let him shower the eternal bliss. Let him make us experience and radiate the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you.